Hello everyone, this is Alex and Mr. Retro Central, and today I'm just going to be showing you how to download Exodus Wallet and how to use it, just briefly. So, why do I pick Exodus Wallet? Well, for starters, it's the most easiest wallet to download and use. So that's one of the main reasons why I use Exodus Wallet. Now, there are other wallets out there. There's some better wallets out there, there's some inferior wallets out there. Personally, I just choose Exodus because it's a wallet that I can just download onto a computer. I can exchange cryptocurrency, like different coins, within Exodus. So I don't need to send to an exchange or transfer or any of that. I can just trade within Exodus if I want certain coins, like Ethereum instead of Bitcoin. So this is the Exodus website, which will be in the description below. You can have a look on the website and just see a bit more things. And I'll just quickly just flick through and... So yeah. Exodus is available for all the operating systems, so you basically just need to just click download, click the version that you want to download it for. There's updates all the time. Within the app, they also let you know when there's a new update so you can download the new update. So that's also another good thing. So as you see, they're adding more currencies and all the stuff all the time. So I already have this. See, even alerts you to when the next update is, and you can go have a look at the releases and stuff like that. You can have a look at the Slack as well if you're proud of Slack. So anyways, I have this already opened because I've already installed it and I already use it. So this is basically what the latest version looks like when it's opened up. So you can see I've got it showing, because you don't necessarily need to show every coin. As you can see in the settings here with the assets, you can pick and choose what you want. I just got them all displayed for the purpose of this video. Now I don't have anything in this wallet because I have other stuff moved around. Okay, so this wallet section here, as you can see, it has all the different coins. To receive and to know what your key is, you just basically click receive. It will show you your public key. And you can print it off if you want the QR code or stuff like that. To send, it's as simple as clicking send, putting in the address, putting in the amount in either US dollars or Bitcoin. Also, you got to remember, it's not the same key for every other coin. That's one mistake a lot of new people make. So every coin will have its own different key. But that's essentially it. It's very easy to back up. Once you've got currency in there, you just simply click this backup button, and then you can enter in an email, and you can also, you got to write down a certain phrase, or like a passcode. To exchange within each other, you just simply click exchange, you select what you want to exchange from and to. So say for example, I want to trade one Bitcoin, I'll get 31 Ethereum, which would be the equivalent in money. It'll show you the fees, etc. So it's very transparent. But I hope this video was informative, and I hope that it helps you. I will also be uploading around the same time videos of how to Bitcoin mine. So this can kind of go hand in hand. So you need a wallet. You need the wallet number. So yeah, they both go hand in hand. So if you're interested in mining, just stay tuned for those videos. I'll be doing them on NiceHash 2.0, 0.1, and NiceHash Legacy. But anyways, I'm Alex from Mr. Retro Central, and thanks for watching.